Speaker Anita Among's decision to adjourn Parliament was in response to a statement tabled by the Attorney General, Chiwanuka Chiriowa, on the elections of administrative units for the LC1 and LC2 chairpersons, whose political term expired on the 10th of July.
The term of the local councils 1 and 2 expired on 10th July 2023. As we all appreciate, this is a serious matter that goes to the very foundation of our governance, which mandates that all power belongs to the people, and the people will express their will and consent to be governed.
The Attorney General asked the chairperson, whose term has expired, to continue rendering services to the public so as to give government time to resolve the apparent void created by the absence of their administrative units.
Government of Uganda is fully seized with this matter, and we are going to come to the House next week with a concrete way forward for the support to ensure. Right, Honourable.
Honourable members, your reaction is premature. Why don't you wait for him to finish, then you debate on the document?
The Speaker asked the Attorney General to explain if there is legitimacy with the decisions being taken by the current LC1 chairpersons, since the Attorney General argued that there is no vacuum.
Attorney General, do you have the statutory instrument that you want to... Do you have it?
The instrument that is required to be done is supposed to be approved by Cabinet, and after approval by Cabinet, must come to Parliament for approval.
The Attorney General replied that his advice is legal and those who doubt it should go to court. His response angered Parliament, and the Speaker called him out for being disrespectful, prompting Chiriowa to withdraw his statement.
Right, Honourable Speaker, the advice I render is legal advice. And if anyone doubts it, they need to go and challenge it in court. So this advice, no, what I'm saying, right, Honourable Speaker, is that the advice I'm rendering is to cover the void.
You know, you're one of my favorite ministers, but now here for you to tell us to go to court.
My sincere apologies, right, Honourable Speaker.
No.
I withdraw that statement.
Thank you.
MPs wondered if the government was intending to declare a state of emergency because it is one of the provisions that call for extension of LC1 elections.
And the Schedule 3, which you are quoting, the provision there for extending their term, it is only when there is war or in the case of a state of emergency. Is government planning to declare a state of emergency?
If anyone goes to court and challenges these agreements, what happens there? Can the Attorney General advise our people on how to operate in their villages?
Wilfred Niwagaba, the Shadow Attorney General, protested the argument fronted by Chiriowa that there is no vacuum and asked Parliament to throw out his statement.
That the statement by the Attorney General be rejected by this House and be expunged from the record.
Honourable members, expunging the statement is not going to solve a problem. What is going to solve the problem is for us to discuss on how to renew, on how to have these members elected.
MPs also scoffed at the proposal by the government to extend the term of office of the LC1 chairpersons so as to fill the vacuum, wondering if similar steps can be taken for vacant parliamentary seats.
Meaning that the lack of legal and political will still exists in the government. Right, Honourable Speaker?
We are the bread workers of the LOC system. Is he in order to insinuate that this government does not have a will to cause the election of LOCs, yet we have the majority in this country? Is he in order?
The atmosphere on the floor of Parliament forced the Speaker to adjourn the House unceremoniously until the government tables clear plans for the LC1 and LC2 elections.
And this House will be adjourned and dying to wait for the statement.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.